Greetings everyone, I am Bhargavi Trivedi and in this video tutorial I will teach you regarding methods of fish farming or you can say aquaculture. So in this video I will be covering the basics of aquaculture, the need of the aquaculture and the different methods that are adapted for doing the aquaculture. This is the part of BECOR BT303 Marine Biotechnology Unit 4 Commercial Potential Semester 5. Let's get started. First, let's understand that what is the basic meaning of the word aquaculture. Now, this term is very much similar to agriculture. Okay. In the agriculture, we use many plants and stuff like that. Okay, so in that case, the plants are replaced with the animals. But which animals? So the animals that live mainly in the aquatic environment, so they are known as aquaculture. So it is the process of rearing, it is the process of breeding and harvesting of the aquatic species of both animals and plants. It controlled aquatic environments like oceans, lakes, rivers, ponds and streams. Okay, so that process is known as aquaculture. Rearing means to making them grow from baby size to the big size so that we can sell them in the market purpose. Breeding means that we are using male and female so in such a way that we can have the best fish out of it. We are harvesting it and it is done for both fresh water and for the marine ocean water. Okay, so we will study that in detail in the after slides and let's understand what is the need for the aquaculture. Okay. The need is first that there is increase in the population in the country. So there is the high demand of the food that is rich in the protein source and all. So mainly people feed on the fish for the best intake of the protein. That's why it is mainly used for the food production. It is used for the restoration of the threatened and endangered species. Nowadays we know that because of the excessive climate change and all, some fish population have become endangered. So in order to make them again come to the normal level, we are using it. Wild stock population enhancement, building of aquariums. Sometimes it is also used for the ornamental production also. That means the fish we can keep at our home in the aquarium for the beautification purpose. Okay, for example, golden fish. Okay, then for fish culture, some people have a craze of sport use of catching the fish, and so because of that, the fish from that river was continuously decreasing. So if we add fish to that, they can fulfill their craziness of fish catching and all, and then we can also use it for the habitat restoration. First, we will study what are the classifications of aquaculture. Now, based on the type of the habitat, we have freshwater aquaculture, saltwater aquaculture, brackish water aquaculture, wastewater aquaculture. Based on the water flow characteristics, we can have running water or we can have standing water. Okay. Standing water means if we do it in the pond, so it will be termed as standing water. Running water, that means some dam or some river flow is constructed and when we are doing it, so that will be termed as the running water. Okay. Based on the type of the culture organism used, then they are classified as finfish culture, crustacean farming, molluscan farming, seaweed farming, live feed culture, algal culture and so on. Then we have, based on the type of the culture matter, we have extensive farming, improved existence, semi-intensive, intensive and super-intensive. Then based on the type of the culture system that is used, now this is the most important. We normally, that is, this is asked in the exams. One is the pond culture, tank culture, open water cultures, raceway cultures, cage and pan culture, recirculation system. Based on the purpose of the culture, as we have seen in the need part, it can be food fish culture, it can be recreation fish farming, it can be bio treatment or the biological treatment. Now, why biological treatment? Because sometimes fish can provide the best protein that or enzymes that can be used for the treatment of some one or other this is. Based on the region, it is classified as warm water aquaculture, cold water aquaculture, subtropical aquaculture, heated water aquaculture. And based on the people involved, it is classified as low level or marginal aquaculture, corporate or entrepreneurial farmer. Now, let's come back to our main point, that what are the organisms that can be cultured in the fresh water? So it can be the simple fish, it can be crustaceans, it can be ornamental fish farming, it can be spirulina. Salt water aquaculture, you can do it for the shrimps, for the crabs and for the live food. Because on the seashore, people, they tend to eat the fish as soon as they get collected. They have a pan frying over there and then they fry it and they eat it. Okay. Now let's talk about the farming methods. So there are so many farming methods that are involved. Pond culture, cages, pan enclosure, raceway, rope, raft, monoculture, polyculture, sewage fed culture, organic culture. We will try to understand few of them in detail. First, let's start with the cage culture. The word itself says the cage. Okay, that means you are trapped in something. Okay, so the cage, they are made up of some nets. Okay, nets, or it can be sometimes made up of copper also. Okay, depending on the quality of the net. So as you can see, the cages, they are of two types. Floating type. This one you can see is, this is of the floating type. Okay, so it is floating on the surface and you can see that the fish, they are growing over here inside it. The cage is in such a way that the water can flow from the cages but the fish cannot go out of it. Okay, then it is the submerged type of the cages. So it is deep in the water. Now, so those places in which it is mainly affected by typhoons and all, the submerged cage is more used. Similar way, we have the pen culture also. Now, it is very similar to the cage system. Okay, but let's see what is the difference between the pen culture and the cage system. As you can see, in the cage system, all the four sides are locked. Okay, first side, this is second side, this is third side, and from the bottom, it is also locked. As you have seen in the figure over here, okay, you have locked at four sides. But what happens in the pen culture is that you are locked from the three sides, but the bottom is not locked. Okay, the natural bottom is used for this. So if the net or the cage is done in three closed types only, so then it will be classified as pen culture. Then you have raceway cultures. Raceway, imagine it is same as the horse race track. Okay, that's why you can see this is the racetrack like system. So what they have done, that they have diverted the natural streams in such a way that they flow through a certain raceway and they are used for growing of fishes. For example, rainbow trout is mainly grown by this way. It is the low risk method and waste must be treated and fish escape is preventive. Okay, because it is having the periphery on the four side, on all the four sides, that's why the fish escape is preventive. What happens in the cage and pen culture, that they are directly in contact with the open water bodies. So there are chances that some fish might escape. But here they are not in direct contact with the open water bodies. So there are less chances of getting escape of the fishes. So you can see over here, this is the raceway pond and the fish are growing over here. I hope it is clear till here. Now let's talk about the monoculture. It's mono, the mono word means single. When in a pond or in any system, only single species is cultured. So that type of culturing, it is referred to as monoculture. For example, only trout is cultured, only tilapia is cultured, only catfishes are cultured, only carp are cultured, only shrimp is cultured. Then let's come to polyculture method. The word poly, that means many. This is also termed as composite fish farming. Okay. So for example, here in this case, more than one fishes are cultured. Okay. But we have to take care that they should have different feeding habits. They should occupy different columns in a pond system. They should attain marketable size at the same time. And they should not be predatory in behavior. We will understand this one by one. Different feeding habits means what? Let's take the example of Katla and Roho. Okay, let's take the example of Katla and Carp. So Katla, they are the surface feeder. They are surface feeder. And this Carp, they are the bottom feeders. Okay, so they are not going to interfere in each other's nutritional conditions. Okay, non-predator, that means Carp, they don't eat Katla. So they are non-predators for each other. Okay. As seen in the figure over here, as you can see over here, that we have different varieties of the species growing on here and all. That's all for this session. And if you have more questions, please email me your questions on bhargavitrivedi.lgis@lginstitute.edu.in. I will be happy to help you. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Bye.